First up, we have the Volkl Power Bridge 4. And the 4 has really been a popular stick for Volkl. They won editor's choice with this model number several years ago in Tennis Magazine. And this racket's always just been that really nice, comfortable racket, kind of, you know, always at the pinnacle of the tweener kind of era frame. So it's not a player's racket, it's not a game improvement racket, it's right in between. So you get that combination of power and control. Really like the feel from the string bed of this one. Get some nice dampened response. It's got that fairly thick beam, so you get nice stability from that, some good stiffness and some nice pop when it goes deep. And you're looking at 105 square inch head size. So again, nice long main strings, good comfortable deep hitting racket. If you're looking for something, you know, it's maneuverable, gonna offer you some easy access to spin, nice blend of control and power, that's a good option. And here we have the Power Bridge 1, which is, features the power arm construction right here in the throat of the racket with a unique Power Bridge material right there. And this is a serious power racket. You get a lot of power out of this one, 115 square inches in the head size, very open string pattern. So it's going to offer a lot of bite on the ball, but also a lot of life coming off, a really lively feel. So a lot of ball speed coming off with very little effort. Here you can see this got a nice thick beam. So they keep the racket lightweight, but with a thick, stiffer beam, you still get some nice stability. And a very maneuverable racket. If your player is just getting started and you're looking for something with a massive sweet spot, going to give you a lot of power, really help your game, you know, and have you instantly having fun and hitting decent shots on the court, this is the kind of racket you want to look at. Power Bridge 1 from Volkl. Let's have a look at some rackets from Yonex now. This one's completely different to the one we just looked at. This one is a player's racket. So features a much smaller head size, 93 square inches, and this is the RDIS 100. This one is being used currently on the tour by Leighton Hewitt, and it has quite a stiff beam for a player's racket. Small head, but the flex is right around 68 points on the RA points on the Babolat RDC machine. And so when you find the sweet spot on this one, you know, you get excellent plow through. Racket really comes to roll through the ball. It's a little brassy outside the sweet spot. But a lot of control, good feel. Love this one on a slice. Really keep the ball low on approach shots. And it's got that isometric head shape. Nice player's racket. And well worth the demo if you're looking for a player's racket with a kind of firmer feel. Jumping into something a bit more user-friendly with its larger 100 square inch head size is the RDIS 300. And so you're really kind of on the cusp of a between a player's racket and a tweener right here. This would have been called a tweener many years ago, but now, you know, so many players are using these larger head size and thicker beam rackets. Standard length racket, nice mobility. It's got a flex of 62, so it's much softer, but it still offers a really nice crisp feel. It's very clean off the string bed. Really like this one, especially in that really clean, crisp feel. Really feel like I'm controlling the ball to specific targets with this one. And again, it's got that nice thick beam, so it's just really solid and very light and maneuverable. I like that stick a lot. Let's have a look at some new rackets from Wilson. This is the K-Pro Team FX. And this features an all-new technology from Wilson and their FX technology right here. They have a groove. So if you see the shaft of the racket is actually separated right here, and that's going to offer you some added stability. It's also going to help keep things very lightweight. This racket features 100 square inch head size, and that's really kind of the golden number these days. And really light, maneuverable racket, comes through the air exceptionally well, excellent access to spin, and a really nice combination of power and control. So very much, you know, really nice lightweight and maneuverable kind of tweener offering right there. Now this one is the K-Tour Team FX. This one features 102 square inch head size. Again, it features that FX technology and the shaft of the racket. And so, you know, even though the racket is fairly light, very maneuverable, you get some really nice stability from that racket. And these rackets are all very comfortable, and I've enjoyed hitting these a lot. Nice open string pattern, so you're gonna get plenty of bite on the ball from the string bed and some nice ball speed off it right there. And you know, if you're a fan of the K-Tour, you know, it was the H-Tour, the N-Tour, now the K-Tour. This one, the team version, a little bit more friendly with a larger head size and a really nice tweener offering. This is the last Wilson racket we're gonna look at, and this is the K1 FX. And this one, you know, features a 122 square inch head size. So it's a really large head size on this racquet. It's got a slight fan design to the string pattern, and it's fairly open, so it's going to offer a lot of bite on the ball. If you like to slice and dice, and again, you're just looking for, you know, massive amount of power and a really generous sweet spot, this is a good stick for you. Again, it has the FX technology in the shaft of the racquet, and then it also features Wilson's connector technology up here on the shoulders of the racquet. And that really does offer a really nice, this piece of graphite here is going to flex independently, and it offers a really nice dampened, very comfortable response on the racquet. So a lot of power, a lot of comfort, and a nice racquet, you know, if you're a beginning player, you know, looking for something to really help your game improve. Last up, we're going to look at some rackets from Dunlop. First up, we have the Dunlop 300 Tour. This is James Blake's new stick. And if you're, you know, a fan of James Blake or you're familiar with his playing style, he is all or nothing. A guy who really likes to try and paint the lines when he goes out there, hits with a lot of aggression. And this racket responds excellently to that kind of hitting. If you really just keep your foot on the gas, the racket just gets better and better. It's got a tight 1820 string pattern, so you get a lot of control. Standard length, nice skinny beam, which all players, you know, advanced level players are going to dig. And a 98 square inch head size. So really love the soft response to this racket. And, you know, the faster I swing, the more I go for my shots, the more I find the groove of this racket. Really nice for the aggressive all-court advanced level player, 4.5 and above. Next up, we have the new version of the 300. So this is the Dunlop Aerogel 300 4D. And it features a new 4D braided graphite construction. And you'll find that in the four corners of the hoop. And this racket is really solid. It feels more of one piece from tip to handle than any 300 I've hit. And I thought the Aerogel 300 was the best yet. I think they've taken it a step further with this 4D version. Very solid, very comfortable, but you're still getting a ton of feel. So you just get that more, you know, solid and stable response, but haven't lost any of the feel of the old 300. Really like that one. Again, 98 square inch head size, great control racket, nice and maneuverable. If you're a really big guy, I just love to hit the ball big. Still plenty of room to add some weight to this one, and a really nice solid playing racket. Like that one a lot. And the last item we're going to look at this week is the Dunlop 550 Lite. This is a 100 square inch racket. It's a much lighter weight racket, so it's more of a tweener kind of offering. It's 27 and a quarter inches long, so you get a bit more leverage on this one. Nice open string pattern. So if you, you know, if you're an intermediate player and you're looking for something that's really easy to get around, this is a dynamite stick and well worth the demo. Again, it has that 4D braided construction in the corners of the racket, and so you get some nice, you know, solidness to the response, but still a lot of feel and superb mobility from this one. Very light and maneuverable. All right, that was a lot of product this week. Thanks for joining me. Be sure to check back with us next week, and we'll go over more new products arriving at the warehouse.